Boobies.
This video and any other videos on this channel are not made for kids.
Where does he get those wonderful toys?
Welcome back, collectors! I'm your host, your friendly neighborhood Moscato Bot, and today we are taking a look at the brand new Ultimate Ash 40th Anniversary Edition from Neca Toys. You can see here already on the front of the packaging we have that poster art. I'm loving the VHS kind of art with the little horror sticker right there. Man, that takes me back. I'm a big VHS collector, if you guys don't know. Definitely going to be doing some type of videos on VHS in the future, but yeah, that horror sticker right there, it is very, very nice. I love it. So here you can see the poster art, the Evil Dead Ultimate Ash, really nice looking there on the front. Top of the box here in the top left, we have the NECA logo, ages 17 and up. Do not put it in your holes, you will die. Evil Dead logo right there in the middle, and we have the Evil Dead 40th Anniversary logo right there with Ash, all bloodied up with the chainsaw. Really cool. Side of the box product shot of Ash, the Evil Dead logo, Evil Dead 40th Anniversary, NECA logo. Other side of the box, the Evil Dead product shot of the figure with a chainsaw this time, Evil Dead 40th Anniversary logo, NECA toys. Back of the box, you guys, we have the Evil Dead logo, a picture of Ash and Linda. Then we have product shots showcasing the figure and the accessories and some of the different poses. We do have a little read up here. I'll go ahead and read that for you guys. Five friends drive to a remote cabin in the woods for a fun getaway. While there, they find the Necronomicon, Ex Mortis, an ancient tome whose text reawakens the dead when read aloud. After unintentionally releasing a flood of evil, the group must fight for their lives or become possessed. Includes three interchangeable heads, chainsaw, axe, shotgun, lantern, tape player, and more. What's the more? Bottom of the box, first off, we have all the beautiful people involved making this figure. Thank you, NECA Toys, so much for figures like these. You bring my childhood and my dreams alive through your action figures. Thank you all so, so much. 2021 Renaissance Pictures, NECA, Real Toys, here is the UPC. Do not put it in your holes, you will die.
Made in the China.
That's more Japanese. I can't do a Chinese thing. Anyways, there's the bottom of the box. There's how the figure looks in the window packaging, but that's gonna go ahead and do it for the packaging, you guys. Let's go ahead and get Ash out of the box. Out of the packaging, I've already been playing with this guy, and oh my god, that likeness, the paint apps, everything is here. Did not have to heat him up right out of the box. He moved perfectly. Ooh, the accessories that come with this guy, everything you would want from a 40th anniversary Ash. Likeness on this head sculpt is incredible. Oh my god, the paint apps. He's even wearing the moccasins. So cool. Down to the accessories, look at the paint apps on the tape recorder. Chainsaw. Alternate hands. Two other heads. One more serious look. One more scared look into the side look. The lantern looks very well done, very well painted. Whoo! I just had to play with him and get a pose going on, but man, is he awesome. So let's go ahead and start with articulation. Head can move side to side all the way around. We get a lot of attitude, a lot of tilt action. Look down that far. Look up about that far. Really great. Again, the likeness on this head. Oh my god. They nailed young. I believe it was 21 years old, 21 or 22 in the first Evil Dead movie. Oh, so good. And again, you guys, look at these paint apps, the buttons, the wrinkles, the sculpting. This blue is just incredible. Even going here onto the back of the figure, going down here to the ass. Ass! But the belt itself is very well sculpted and painted right on there into the jean straps or the belt straps on the jeans or the pants. Crotch, sculpted, wrinkles all the way down. The moccasins look fantastic. Very well done. But okay, I had to point that out. The sculpt is incredible. All right, so we went over the head. Arms can go out about that far. Back in. Again, this is going to hinder it a little bit here in the shoulder. You can see that. Can't go past that right there. And then we can rotate 360 all the way around. Single jointed elbow, but you can get a little past 90 right there. Pretty good. Rotation here at the bicep. And rotation here at the wrist. And it is on a hinge for up and down swivel pivot. Great, grand, wonderful. Let's go ahead and move these up. Legs can go out that far. I'm loving the ball joint system. Keep it up, NECA. Way better than the whole ratchet situation. We can kick out that far and kick back that far. I mean, almost get him doing the full-blown splits. That's really good. I mean, you want him to kick out side to side. Look at that. Van Damme it, if you will. I mean, it gets the articulation that you want. We do have a swivel here at the upper leg, thigh. There we go. Single jointed at the knee, and it does rotate all the way around. Again, did not have to heat this up. Foot here on the foot.
The foot.
We can hinge up, down, back, and we do get that nice pivot. Very nicely done. And we get rotation here at the waist. He does what you want him to do. Not that you're gonna get Ash in some crazy kung fu poses, but God, it's everything you want, everything you need with this figure. And while I got you here, we're gonna go ahead and just pop this head off like so. You can see the ball joint there. We'll go ahead and we'll grab another head. If I can see what I'm doing behind the camera. There we go. This is the one that actually came on the figure. And the likeness is spectacular on this one as well. I just like the other one a little bit better. And just pops on like so. Look around. Look at all that tilt, action, and motion. Very, very nicely done. You can see Bruce Campbell. Just the jawline. God damn, does that boy have a beautiful jaw. Go ahead and we'll swivel out here at the wrist. Take that out. You guys can see you just peg in the alternate hands. Well, we got the wrong hand out. But just to show you guys, this is how you peg it in. Like so. Really simple. Obviously, it's for this hand. Not the left hand. But yeah. Just so you guys know, okay? Here's a close-up on the third head. More of the scared looking kind of to the side or behind him. Trying to see what's going to be behind him. Head. This one's okay. Not too great. My eyes are a little powdery on this one, but I was never going to use this one anyways. I mean, it's still great. The likeness is there and everything, and, you know, I mean, you really got to get up close to kind of see that foggy eye thing going on, but it still looks immaculate. I mean, it looks great. It really does, but I'm just not going to use this head sculpt, but you can see how well sculpted it is, the hair and everything, so I just wanted to show that off so you guys can see it. There's a third head. Well, I got ya. Here are the other alternate hands. You can see for gripping the chainsaw and the shotgun. Speaking of the shotgun, here it is in all of its glory, right before it becomes the boomstick. You can see that there. Very nicely done, well painted. Even here on the stock, the handle here as well, the wood, it looks real. Look at the sculpt here, it even feels the texture. Very nicely done. Loving that. Shh. showing off more of the weapons. Here is the axe. Now, I think this axe is wrong. The one in the movie was not a double-headed axe like this one. This is more, you know, Silent Night, Deadly Night. Unless I'm wrong, but I just watched the movie yesterday. On VHS, of course. But, yeah, it's a single-headed axe like that. Not like this. Unless I'm missing it somewhere. I did fall asleep because I'm 34, and now that's what I do. I guess when I watch movies, I doze off because I'm getting older. But the sculpt, incredible. The paint apps, incredible. The handle, incredible. Just really great looking axe. What I might do, and I need to rewatch, and obviously comment down below, you guys, if for sure in The Evil Dead, the first film, it's a single-headed axe, you know? That's what I think. So I don't know why we got this one. Maybe just throwing any axe there, I don't know. But I definitely have a single-headed axe with some of my Jason figures, so I might swap that out. But there is the axe that comes with this figure. Of course, such an iconic weapon and tool for this film and the franchise is the chainsaw. And how it looks before he modifies it in Evil Dead 2. But very well done. Loving this. Paint apps are great. Pretty durable. Liking it a lot. There we go. Ash is an Ash without a chainsaw. He does come with a lantern. Very nicely detailed. Wish it lit up, that'd be kind of cool. I really hope NECA starts bringing back more of the LED effects, but I guess with the inflation and price increase with action figures and, well, everything nowadays, maybe it's better that it's not an LED light-up lamp, because probably would have been another $8 or so. So I still would have bought it either way. But still cool.
May be recalled to active life through the incantations presented in this book. It is through recitation of these passages that the demons are given license to possess the living.
Tatra amistrobin hazarta. Tantir mano mansizon hazan sobar. Saman la robza. Darhis haiker dans de rodza. Ganda.
Shut it off.
Kanda.
Shut it off.
Kanda.
Shut it off!
And to me, the scariest scene in the entire movie is kind of the whole mystery behind the tape and the book. And here we have the tape recorder. So very nice accessory to throw in with the 40th anniversary Ash. Because of this, everything went to shit. But again, you can see very well painted, sculpted. I mean, they went all out. Look at the bottom of this thing. The textures on it. Very nicely done. And Ash stands approximately just under 7 inches. And for some quick comparisons, here is Ash next to NECA Toys Ultimate Frankenwrath. Frankenwrath being really bulky and weight... About another whole inch taller than Ash is, but see, right there. And swapping out Frankenwrath for another 40th anniversary Ash, this time from Alien. See those two, how they look together? Evil Dead Ash is a little bit taller than Alien Ash. Some Back to the Future love. Here is Ash next to Tales from Space Marty McFly. Still need to get a Griff. Really need Griff. Now, I don't know much about Defenders of the Earth, but I do know that I love this Ming figure. I'm gonna go ahead and throw him up right there next to Ash. Spread Ash out a little bit more there. There we go. All I can say is this is one of my favorite action figures of all time out of my whole collection. Just the colors pop on this guy. He is so good. I may have to review him one of these days, but this Ming is just breathtaking. The cape, the colors, it's everything I love about this figure. Again, I don't know anything about Defenders of the Earth, but I do know that I like the cheesy Flash Gordon movie from the 80s. But yeah, just one of my favorite figures. So I said, you know what? He's a fun one. We haven't looked at him in a while. There he is next to Ash. Let's throw up a little bit of a smaller figure, but keeping the NECA and Turtle Love going. There he is next to the Disguise Raph. Move Raph a little bit back so you guys can see. Stand up, Raph. There we go. God, I love that pose I got on him. These figures just look great together. And you can kind of see the backdrop there of all the other figures I collect. We got the Thing. We got more Evil Dead figures. In fact, and finally, you guys, here we kind of have Ash throughout the years. We have, of course, Evil Dead Ash, Evil Dead 2 Hero Ash, kind of the day after, if you will. And then approximately, what, 30-something years later, Ash? So, yeah, he's been through a lot. But I love this character's arc of how he goes from kind of like a scaredy cat wimp to cutting up his girlfriend to the hero that he has to become, especially in Army of Darkness. And Army of Darkness is my favorite. I know, I'm the campy type of guy. I like that stuff. Evil Dead 1 and 2 are pretty creepy, but God, when Ash becomes who the Ash that we love, especially the one in Ash vs. Evil Dead, there's nothing better for the character, for me, anyways. But yeah, I definitely am loving this whole set of figures to kind of see where Ash has been throughout the years. Now, if we can just get that Evil Dead, Army of Darkness Ash with the cape and ultimate form. So many possibilities they could do with that movie. Please, NECA Toys, give us some Army of Darkness love. We know it's campy, but we love it, and it's what made the character of Ash who he is today. Alright guys, we've gone over the packaging, the accessories, the articulation, the comparisons. Let's get to my favorite part of the video, the showcase. Here we go. Another one for the books, Moscato Bots. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it.
If you guys liked the video, please hit that thumbs up. It really helps out. And subscribe. Don't forget,
play with your toys.
This guy right now, I believe, is a timed NECA Haulathon exclusive. You can get him at your local Target. That's it for right now. I hope he's going to be available. Now, don't quote me on this, you guys. I'm like 90% sure he's a time exclusive at Target. Then later on, he'll be available at your local comic shops and all that jazz and stuff like Big Bad Toy Store and Dorkside Toys. But for right now, get to your local Targets. There's a lot of NECA goodness going on with this Haulathon thing at Targets, especially with Ninja Turtles. We have Demona. Now we're going to be getting Bronx from the Gargoyles line, Elvira. So many figures coming out. Next week, Turtle Tuesday, March 22nd, we have the Secret of the Ooze VHS pack coming, plus the accessory pack, which you guys know I'm a huge Ninja Turtle fan. You can see over there off in the right-hand corner, my Ninja Turtle movie line. I'm so ready, you know, been working a lot of overtime for action figures, plus I also need to get ahead in life because, you know, what, I got a house here, it's been 2 years and we're still fixing it up, and I just need money. But I keep buying fucking toys. What are you gonna do? Anyways, you guys, that's gonna do it for this video. So thank you all so much for watching. Till all are one with Scuttlebots, you all stay classy. I will see you all in the next one. Which should be... I'll go ahead and turn the camera real quick. Don't mind my shitty lamps. But we have the Universal Monsters. We've already done Frankenstein. So Wolfman and Mummy are next. Let me know down below in the comments which one you want to see next. So... first comment, that's the one I'm doing next. But anyways, you guys, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. Moscato Bots, roll out.